Today, we'll learn how to make and use a control chart from the 7 QC tools. Hi, this is Magnami, Lean Sigma Black Belt. Control charts are often used in the improve phase and control phase in DMake. But it is not used much in service operation improvement since there is a need to collect data on a regular basis. However, the concept of monitoring operational data and taking preventive action is fundamental in Kaizen activities. So we'll learn the control chart today. I made a control chart template. Please try it by clicking the link in this video's description as usual. Before going into the template explanation, I have a little announcement. I've been making templates in English and Japanese. This time, I added a Spanish version. There is a link in this video's description to go to the English free download page, where you can go to the Spanish and Japanese free download pages. This is the template sheet. There are 7 types of control charts, depending on what kind of data you use. This template is the most commonly used Xbar-R control chart. First, prepare your measured data on Excel. In this example, this has one set of 5 operational times in a row for 30 days vertically in time series. After opening the file, on the template file, double-click here, then follow each message and click yes or no depending on your situation. Here, Excel is asking where your data is. Select your data in a maximum of 5 columns with your mouse and click OK. Then this is the result. 2 charts appeared. This column shows each set of 5's average. Those averages are plotted in yellow in the above chart. In the chart, the upper and lower lines are control limit lines. In short, if your plots go out of the lines, there would be an abnormality. In other words, a special cause in your process. Here it is. Next, this column shows the differences between each maximum value and minimum value of each set of 5 data. We call it range R. Those range R's are plotted in gray in the R control chart below. You can see variations in your data from the chart. Returning to the first worksheet of the template, there is the interpretation and action plan section. Let's read it. 1. Create this control chart when special causes, which will be explained next, are shown in your control chart, identify a root cause in your process and take preventive actions. 2. A special cause is a signal that some abnormality in the process may have occurred. In the control chart, they are represented when the following symptoms appear. A. When plots are beyond the upper or lower control limit line. We've already learned this. B. Even within the control limit lines, when there are 7 or more consecutive plots above or below the average line, they look like this. C. Even within the control limit lines, when there were 7 or more consecutive plots trending up or down, they look like this. In order to remember these 4 special causes easily, we call them the rule of 7. Since there are more definitions of special causes in other companies and industries, it's a good idea to add applicable ones to your company's practice. You can use this control chart effectively in the check stage of the PDCA cycle. Even in service industries, you can use it when you collect data on a regular basis. Even if not, it's still a good idea to use it for a limited time. Thank you very much for viewing. Please click the subscribe button. Also, click and watch my other related videos. Thanks.